I don't have to introduce Lakshmi to this gathering, but she is above all a very dear friend of mine. And also, authority also reside in the country and in the region. She is part of many international bodies who work on suicide and has written very widely on the subject, probably the most widely read and written person in India today on the topic. And like Shekhar said, runs an extremely successful helpline because of which we have invited her here. So I'm just going to hand it over to Lakshmi now and she'll take it over.
Thank you very much for inviting me, Prabha, because it's almost, I just realized it's almost 15 years since I've come to him and it's grown, and I think as she said, more than anything else, I value what she said about being a friend, and it's very important that we are there for our friends. And straight away, I'm inviting Shekhar for the conference which I'm going to have next year. After 11 years, we are going to have an international conference on suicide. Okay. I'm not going to go too much on slides. I'm just going to kind of start the ball rolling. So what is important is the fact that you're there. The fact that you're there at the end of the helpline, willing to listen to somebody, to be there for somebody and understand, is enough for a variety of people. Why I'm saying this, many times we come back feeling that we have been helpless, we have not done anything, we couldn't do anything, things like that. But somewhere it has an effect. But the most important thing that helpline should have is confidentiality. If you compromise on your confidentiality, your helpline is doomed. Somebody was not answered. Okay, what do you feel about suicide?
I'm not very negative about it. So,
okay. What do you feel about suicide?
What I feel is, one of the things when I ask my clients about
suicide. No. Forget about it. Give me one word. What do you feel about suicide?
Scary. Like a sense of helplessness.
Okay.
For the person and.
Yeah. Escape.
Cowardice.
Impulsive.
Last way out.
I'm asking what you feel about suicide. And all of you have answered what you think about suicide. It is cowardice, it is bravery, it is hopeless, it is frustrating. That is, it is not me. Okay? It happens to somebody, the feeling is something else. That's why two, three people I repeatedly ask, what do you feel? What do you feel? Immediately, my client, it, that, this. We never associate I with it. So if a person who you say is a suicide helpline and people call and you don't ask that, it will be like that. And for many people, they themselves are going through a confusion in their mind. They themselves would not have been able to verbalize. Okay? It will be very difficult for her to say, I am feeling suicidal to her. Okay? But if she asks the question, it is easy for her to say yes. Sometimes it's a huge relief for them to say yes because they are so confused. These negative thoughts keep going in and around their mind and they don't know how to cope with it. And somebody really understanding and asking the question and all I have to say an yes is a big relief. Okay?
How long is your average contact with the client?
Normally, on an average, if it's a visit, it always longer. It's about an hour and a half to two. But if it's a phone call, it's about 40 minutes.
Because you have that much of time to take, to lead to that.
Yeah.
So you said, you,
I mean, we don't have any. See, there have been times when you have had calls for 4 hours.